Here, we discuss a question. This is a circuit, and here question is to find each branch current by using mesh analysis method. So first, you find how many number of mesh are there, or loop are there. Two loop are there. One and mesh or loop two. You assign the loop current either clockwise or anti-clockwise direction. Here I assume clockwise direction of current I1 and I2. Then you write KVL equation for each loop. First I write KVL equation for loop 1. Loop 1 comprises of voltage source 80 volt and 2 resistors 5 and 4. 1 voltage source is there and 2 draw voltages are there. In this battery, the current flowing from negative polarity to positive polarity. So its polarity is positive, that is 80. Voltage drop you assume as a negative. Supply is positive, drop or consumed are negative. Voltage drop across 5 is 5 into current I1 minus 5 into I1. Voltage drop across 4 ohm resistor is its resistance into current. Here both loop 1 and loop 2 current flows and their current direction are opposite to each other. Hence the resulting current is subtraction of these two current. As you write equation for loop 1, loop 1 current you assume as a greater. Hence I1 minus I2 equal to 0. Algebraic sum of voltages or potential drops in a closed circuit is equal to 0. Then you solve this equation. If you solve this equation, you get I directly write the equation. This is equation 1. Then you write KVL equation for loop 2. Loop 2, it consists of only resistances. So sum of the voltage drop is equal to 0. Across 4 ohm resistor, both current flows I1 and I2. As you write KVL equation for loop 2, you assume its current is greater than the neighboring loop current. So I2 minus I1. As it is a voltage drop, polarity is negative. Then across 2 ohm resistor, 2 into current flowing through 2 ohm is only I2, not I1. Only I2 current flows through 2 ohm resistor. So voltage drop across 2 ohm resistor is 2 into I2. Then across 1 ohm, 1 into I2 is equal to 0. If you simplify this equation, you get, means you take I2 common, you get the equation is equation 1 and 2. It shows two equation, two unknown. After solving either by cancellation method or matrix method, you find the value for I1 and I2. After solving this, you get I1 as 11.9 ampere and I2 as 6.8 ampere. After finding this loop current I1 and I2, see, here both currents you get positive, means your assumed direction are also equal to the original direction. In the original circuit, if you connect this voltage source, then yes, original correct direction is in this direction. Okay. Now you find, as my question is to find each branch current. So here also you find each branch current across 5 ohm resistor, sorry, through 5 ohm resistor, current flowing is I1, that is equal to 11.9 ampere. Through 4 ohm resistor, current flowing is the subtraction of the I1 and I2 current. Now after solving, you get I1 current is greater and I2 current is smaller. So you subtract I1 from I2. I1 minus I2, it is 5.1 ampere. Through 2 ohm and 1 ohm, same current, that is I2 current, flows. Through 2 ohm and 1 ohm, I2 current flows, which value is 6.8 ampere. This is the second question. Here I include one current source of 3 ampere. The same here also, you have to find each branch current by using mesh analysis method. Here you find number of loop. 3 loop are there, 1, 2, and 3. Here in this circuit, 3 mesh or loop are there. You assign loop current here. Let this is loop 1. I assume current direction as a clockwise, and I take I1 current. Here let I2 current flows, and on the upper loop already current direction is given and also magnitude is given. So I take that current direction in anticlockwise. Always the current direction is given here. It is 3 ampere. Now for each loop, you write KVL equation. For loop 1, let this is 1, 2, this one is 3. For loop 1, it consists of 3 voltages, 3 type of potential differences. One is the battery voltage, another is the voltage drop across 5 ohm, another is the voltage drop across 4 ohm. So this potential differences is equal to 0. Summation of this potential differences is equal to 0. 80 volt, it is a source, 5 and 4 are the draw voltages. So source voltages you assume positive, draw voltages you assume negative. Another is option, here you check that how current is flows through this battery source. It is negative to positive or positive to negative. Here the current direction is from negative to positive. In this direction current flows here. Polarity is positive. Then voltage drop across 5 ohm resistor. Polarity is negative. 5 into current flowing through 5 ohm. 5 ohm is common for loop 1 and loop 3. So both current flows. If you see here, current direction through 5 ohm, that is I1, is forward, and this current 3 ampere, it is also forward. So as I1 current and 3 ampere current are same direction, they are additive. Then voltage drop across 4 ohm resistor. Here also 4 ohm is common for loop 1 and loop 2. So both current flows here, I1 and I2 are opposite to each other. So the resulting current is the subtraction of I1 and I2. Which one greater, I1 or I2? You do not know. So here as you write KVL equation for loop 1, you assume I1 as greater. I1 minus I2 is equal to 0. This is equation 1. Then you write equation 4 loop 2. In loop 2, no voltage source is there, no battery present here, only resistors. So sum of the voltage drop is equal to 0 across 4 ohm. I1, I2 both flows, they are in opposite direction. You write I2 minus I1 because here I write KVL equation for loop 2. Hence I assume I2 is greater than I1. Then through 2 ohm, both 3 ampere and I2 current flows. I2 and 3 ampere in this direction, I2 also same direction. So the resulting current through 2 ohm is addition of I2 current and 3 ampere current. Addition of I2 and 3 ampere. Then voltage drop across 1 ohm. 1 ohm into I2, only I2 current flows, equal to 0. This is equation 2. You simplify these two equations. Here, no need to write loop 3 equation, because loop 3 current, direction and magnitude is already given. No need to find KVL equation for loop 3. You solve equation 1 and 2. If you solve this equation, you get that this is equation 3. Equation 3 and 4, it represent two unknown, two equation. I1 and I2 are the unknown parameter. So either by cancellation method or matrix method, you find the value of I1 and I2 as here I1 is 9.17 ampere and I2 is 4.38 ampere.